Hello everyone and welcome back. So last week we left you after everything went wrong. Luckily also this kind of crappy time found an end and we were headed north past Dubrovnik all the way to Korčula, one of the diamonds of the Mediterranean Sea.
Friday the 14th of August, we are currently passing Korčula and on the way to pick up two of our interns tomorrow and the day after in Bela Luka, which is on the western shore of Korčula, so really nice place.
A couple of new species of algae and other things. So for algae, I think I saw more different species here than I've seen everywhere else, but it might also be the fact that I've been learning more about them.
Yeah.
So now I start looking out for them. But overall, great day.
For those of you who don't know, my name is Tawani and I am a South African and I am currently studying my bachelor's degree in Hungary for wildlife conservation and management. The first theory that I would look at would be, we noticed that in the beginning there was a specific anemone that wasn't really present in the beginning of our trip, and so when near to the end of our trip, which was like a couple of days ago, we saw them, it was like seagrass, it was just everywhere. So I realized that there's a lot of factors that can be included in things like this, like water salinity, temperature, depth, all of these things. So my theory would be that perhaps closer to the north, they are more visible, because that is what I have found. I don't know if this theory is correct, but hopefully Project Manaia can help me to work this out on their journeys further on. My second theory that I have has to do with the amount of species that we need to learn on board here. And as much fun as it is, in the beginning, I didn't know much. And so my theory would be that if you do not know the species, does that mean they do not exist in the area that you're in? Because there's, as time collected and we got to know species a little bit better. I am putting all of the species in this book onto this file so that we can see which fish and which species of everything was everywhere where we went. I don't know if that's kind of sense. We didn't see those species in the beginning, where now when we go out, we can actually look for those species and we see them. So it's a lot easier to recognize and to realize when you've seen a new species that you haven't seen in other areas. So yeah, those are my two theories that I have. The second one was supposed to be funny.
Hello. Bastard. So would you like to tell what you're doing in general after your transects?
We
put the data of the fish species that we've seen, as well as the mapping of the seagrass and rocks and sand, and we add the data to the Excel spreadsheets, and we sort the photos into files so that we can find them a little bit easier. And at the moment, we're also searching for English names for all of the Latin names of all the species, which is interesting.
So this was Tawani. She stayed on board with us for about 2 weeks, which was, well, ultimately not really long enough. But in the next weeks, there's a few more people who joined us this season who you will get to know, also their projects and what they've been working on. And also, if you would like to join us in one of our next expeditions in the coming season, the schedule is about to come up on the website. That being said, we will hang around the Mediterranean again. We're just not 100% sure yet if we're going east or west. So, either back to Greece or around Italy and towards the Spanish shores. But more about that in the next one, and of course on the website. So stay tuned and make sure to check back. Bye guys!